Hi, this is CAD/CAM Lessons channel, and this is another video where I show how I'm learning Blender. And in the previous video, I created a model, and after finishing, I decided I wanted to add fillet or chamfers to the edges. It turned out that it wasn't so simple. First, I tried to do it by selecting the bevel command from the modifiers. This command was associated with blunting the edges, so I thought it was what I wanted to use. However, I didn't see an option to selecting the edges. I had selected the edge, but I couldn't select them on the model. Looking for a solution, I got information on how to handle this. First, I created a copy of the model to avoid making changes to the original. I selected copy, then paste. And the shape was pasted. New elements appeared, but now when I turn off the model's visibility, it looks like this. We have two elements, and I will work on this copy. And to be able to select edges, you need to switch to edit mode. First, select the shape you want to edit and choose edit mode. You can use Tab key. The edges were displayed, but only the top face edges. Switch to Edge Selection because Vertex Selection was the default. And we can only select edges on the top face. I noticed that modifiers were added. I thought it was the operation history, but after expanding the arrow, I saw the apply command. This means that the modifiers are displayed as if they were used, but they are not actually applied to the 3D model. I switched to object mode. Expand the arrow next to the modifier, select apply. And after adding modifiers, will they be applied to the shape? And edges can be selected. I switch back to edit mode and now I can select edges. We can add a chamfer and a fillet to the edges. From the edge menu, I select the bevel edges command, select the edge, drag the mouse and click, and we have parameters. One segment is a chamfer, increasing the number of segments is a fillet. We can also add chamfers or fillets to vertices. I switch to vertex selection, select the vertex, choose the command, and set the parameters. Then switch to object mode. It is possible that chamfering and rounding edges can be done differently, but I haven't figured it out yet. I'm wondering how to add chamfer or fillet to the edges of circles, which consists of many points or edges. But for now, I'll leave the topic of chamfers and rounding. The information on how to add chamfers and fillets to long edges is enough for me. And as for chamfering and rounding holes, it might be explained in a later stage of learning. I switch to object mode. We have a shape with chamfers and roundings and the original shape. And in the last video about the Blender, I added chamfer and fillets to the shape. However, I started to wonder that in this case, a better solution would be to add chamfers and fillets at the sketch stage, at the flat geometry stage. Adding chamfer and fillets at the flat geometry stage could be easier and faster, and in this video I'll show you how to do it. Let's start a new project. Okay, I'll remove the cube and add a new sketch on the XY plane. Okay, I'll draw a rectangle. Okay, and right click to cancel the rectangle drawing. And when it comes to adding chamfer and fillets at the flat geometry stage, we have such options. At the sketch stage, we can add a fillet, and here we have the bevel option. By selecting this option, we can select the vertex and we can add fillet here. Here are the parameters for this fillet, and we can specify the radius of this fillet. Okay. However, when it comes to adding chamfers, we don't have such an operation, but we can create a line that will start on one line and end on another line. And now we can simply trim this piece of geometry, select trim command and select the geometry to be trimmed. And now we can specify the dimensions of this bevel. But we can also use other commands for adding chamfers and fillets. I'll delete this sketch. Let's cancel this command, select all geometry and press delete key. And let's create another rectangle here. Okay. Here as convert type, select mesh and leave the sketch. And now we have the flat geometry. And now we can also add chamfer and fillets to such geometry. We can do this in two ways. We can add chamfers and fillets using modifiers. Now I'll switch to the edit mode. And here, add modifier, select generate bevel modifier, and here select vertices, select the vertex, and specify the size. For example, 2 millimeters. Okay. Now we have chamfers in all corners, and if we change the number of segments, a fillet will be added here. This way, I've managed to add chamfers and fillets to all corners. However, if I wanted to add a chamfer or fillet to a single corner, we can do it just like when adding chamfers and fillets in the previous video. We simply use this command. Okay, I'll remove this modifier. Select vertex, bevel vertices, and move the cursor to specify the chamfer or fillet. And here we have the parameters and we can specify size, for example, 2 millimeters. And if you want to get a fillet, then you need to change the number of segments. Okay, once again, select vertex, bevel vertices, specify the chamfer or fillet, here specify the size and number of segments. One segment is chamfer and more segments is fillet. Okay, exit the edit mode, switch to object mode, and based on this geometry we can create a solid. Here we can add solidify modifier, select modifier, generate solidify, and specify the thickness. And now I know that when I want to create chamfers and fillets in the corners of the solid, it may be better to add such bevels at the flat geometry stage. And that's all for today. There may be other ways to add chamfers and fillets, but at this stage that's enough for me. So thanks for watching and please subscribe to this channel.